A perfect swaddle is the closest a baby can get to the comfort of her mother's womb. And according to my husband, this is the most underrated skill in parenting, the swaddling. So in today's video, I'm going to show you how I used to swaddle my baby and talk a little about its benefits and also give you my safety tips. The first thing we do after the child is born is wrap her up in a light, breathable cloth. This is an age-old practice, and now we know that it's super helpful because the baby needs to feel calm, snug and secure, just like she did inside the womb. The snug wrap also prevents her from waking up with her uncontrolled movements, and I know all this firsthand because I have done it myself for the first 3 to 4 months with my daughter Miraya. Yes, and she's also going to be our model for today. Now she's 6 months old, so she's a bit old to be swaddled, and she's a bit more active compared to when she was a newborn, and a lot more stronger and louder as well. And she's definitely going to resist me when I try to swaddle her, but I'll try and show anyway. Let's hope she cooperates. I'll show you two methods of doing this today. First one is for a newborn. When Miraya was a newborn, I kept her swaddled pretty much all the time. She slept for like 16 hours a day, and she was swaddled pretty much every time that she slept. So you can swaddle using a nice soft cotton or a muslin cloth, or you can buy the ready available ones with Velcro. See, I personally prefer the muslin ones, or even better, grandma's old cotton saris. See, these can be used later when the baby grows up as a towel or to just put on as a mattress cover. So it has multiple uses and you will not have to throw it away. And I have noticed that the ready-made ones with the Velcro, they tend to scratch the baby or it just tears off while washing regularly. Now, some of these swaddle cloths I found online were quite small, you know, only 100 by 100 centimeters. And my experience is that you need at least 120 by 120 centimeter size, the large cloth, or say 48 inches and not the 40 inches one. See, your baby outgrows the small 40 inches one pretty quickly within a month or so. So it's best to buy the long one. All right, so let's see now how to correctly swaddle the baby. Now I've taken a soft cloth and I'll show you how to lay it onto a flat surface. Just lay it out flat, straighten it out. Now place the baby in the center. Again, this is near her neckline or her shoulder line without covering her neck or her head. Now here you will keep one arm straight and try to tuck it diagonally onto the other side between her right hand and her right side of the body. I'll tuck it below her. This is diagonal, keeping only one arm straight. Now we go down near her legs. The part below her legs, we bring it up. The newborn, this is mainly for the newborns, but newborns don't move so much. She's a naughty child. Now we bring the right hand down, straight, and from the right side, turn this flap and take it below her body. Yes. Now giving it a nice and a snug fit. So her hands have been held secure, but you can see she's moving her legs. That means her hip has a lot of space to wriggle around. Her legs also have a lot of space. So that was method number one, which I used for the first few weeks when she was very small. See, for newborns, you should not tie tightly or put a knot, as you don't want to injure them in any way. That's why you saw that I just wrapped the cloth but did not tie a knot of any kind. But as she grew older, she started moving her hands a lot. So I switched to the second method, which I'll show you now. Now let's take a nice soft muslin cloth and lay it flat on the surface. And fold just one end of this. Bring it down. One corner, I have brought it down. So this becomes a rough diamond shape. Just straighten out, smoothen out everything. All the folds and creases I have smoothened out. Yeah. Now place the baby in the center. See where you're positioning it, right below her neck. Now start by folding one side onto both her arms. Straighten her arms and fold this and tuck it right below her. Now you have the loose end of the legs. I just fold them and hold it here or tuck it here. Now I have a nice long tail on one side, which I will just turn around and take it below her, bring it forward in a snug fit and just tuck it here. Now you can see she's able to move her head, her neck, so she's comfortable here. Plus her legs are pretty open and free. So she's able to move her hips. However, her hands have been held securely and in a snug fit. So that was my second way of swaddling. I used this method from when she was around 1 month old till around 3 or 4 months old. See, swaddling in general helped me a lot with her sleep. She was able to sleep longer and better when she was swaddled properly. Plus, it kept her flailing hands off her face. See, babies have a lot of uncontrolled movements in their initial months, and swaddling will help keep them snug and very secure. Some babies even have trouble sleeping on their backs because of the startle reflex, meaning they just wake up with a shock or a jerk, and that disturbs their sleep. See, swaddling will help reduce that as well. Now, another extremely important benefit that I experienced was when she was having colics. I would just swaddle her, rock her, sing to her, and that would immediately just soothe her down. Next up, I would like to tell you are my safety guidelines about how to safely swaddle your baby. Number one, don't wrap too tightly. Just leave some wriggle room. Otherwise, there could be hip problems. So I keep the hips loose every time. Now, number two, if you wrap too loosely, then it can increase the risk of suffocation. See, if it's too loose and the baby raises her arms, she'll cover her face with the cloth and may get suffocated. Now, number three, another risk of suffocation is if you swaddle the baby and put her on her tummy or onto the side. So, don't put her on her tummy or on the side after swaddling. After swaddling, babies should sleep on their back only. Now, number four, I strongly feel if you swaddle your baby, then you should always, always monitor her while she's sleeping. Now, next is babies should only have their body wrapped and not their neck or the head like I showed you. She should always be able to move her head and breathe without any hindrance or difficulty. And the last point I would like to say is use a very soft muslin cloth or a light cotton cloth. See, this is a breathable material. I also love the old soft cotton saris. Now make sure your baby doesn't overheat because of a thick blanket. Always look for signs of sweating or damp hair. Also, whenever you're swaddling, just put some light clothes inside. Lastly, swaddling is not really mandatory. If your baby is happy without it, don't bother swaddling her. But most babies love it, you know, because it just reminds them of their time inside the tummy, just the way they like white noise. Plus, swaddling is also done only in the fourth trimester, meaning only for the first 3 or 4 months after birth. Stop swaddling if your baby grows old enough to try to roll over. Some babies may start rolling over at 3 or 4 months, some may be later. See, Miraya is almost 5 months old and she is still trying to roll over. Her swaddle is not really snug now. I just keep her feet open pretty much all the time and just lightly cover her up. Alright, thank you for making it to the end of this video. I hope you found it informative. Do share your views in the comment section below and don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Until next time, Namaste.